Hey everyone, Corey here with another DIY, and today we're going to be changing the coolant temperature sensor on this B6A4 Ultrasport behind me. Now this is going to be applicable for any model in the Volkswagen Audi lineup that comes with a 1.8T. So Mark IV Jettas, Mark IV Golfs, B5A4s, and early B6A4s as well. So this sensor failed in two ways. One, it is transmitting incorrect data to the ECM, and two, it's leaking coolant around the O-ring and down the heater hose. It's a simple 4-pin thermistor. 2 pins go to the instrument cluster, 2 pins go to the ECM. So it can be reading fine going to the instrument cluster, but not be fine going to the ECM. When they fail, they either make the coolant temperature read super low or super high, which activates the cooling fans. Most of the time, this will fail one of two ways. Either the instrument cluster will not read right or the ECM will not read right. If you think your thermostat is failing because the instrument cluster is showing it's overheating, just double check the data at the ECU. So this is a fairly simple DIY. Shouldn't take much time at all. I'll show you how to do it real quick and let's take a look at the tools required. So tools required for this job, good flashlight, a pick if the O-ring does not come out with the sensor, various flathead screwdrivers to get the clip off, a mirror so you can see behind it and make sure the O-ring is not folding over and if you secure the sensor the correct way. And the coolant pressure tester is optional. It's just an easy way to check your work before you put it all together. So now that we looked at the tools required, let's dive in. So you can do this one of two ways. You can either take apart all the PCB hoses in the back to gain access to the sensor, or you can tilt the motor forward. So since this is on a lift, I'm going to raise it up and then lower the back of the transmission very lightly on a jack stand, which will tilt the motor forward. If you're doing this at home, you can just use a floor jack and tilt it a little bit, but you have to be very careful because you can crack the tail case on the transmission.
So when you're trying to tilt the engine to increase the space on the back of the motor, you want to try to jack it from this point right here so that it will tilt the most. You want to try to avoid lifting it on this case here because you can crack it. Another thing you can do is also undo the transmission mount bolts here so it'll lift up a little bit easier, but that is not necessary. So if you were doing this on the floor, you would jack up one side of the car so you get a good view and can fit your jack stand under the car. You get it in place and put it on this bolt here, and then slowly lower the car, watching how much space you get. You don't want to do too much, just enough to get your hands in there.
So now that I have the engine tilted a little bit, we have just enough room for me to get back there and replace the sensor. So I have my new sensor already prepped, new O-ring on it and lubricated, and a new clip handy as well. So I am going to take a small screwdriver, reach around the engine and get this clip underneath. So that's 3/4 of the way out.
Uninstalling the clip, you want to reach down with a long screwdriver or a pick and simply just rotate it. And then you can sneak your hand around the cylinder head and pop it the rest of the way.
Now you're going to reach down there, wiggle the sensor loose. There we go. Popped out. As you can see, sensor came out. It's easier to pull it out with the wiring harness, and the O-ring is still in the pipe, so we gotta get a pick and get the O-ring out of there. So as you can see on this car, it was leaking coolant through the sensor. So hopefully we can clean out the wires enough to where it'll read correctly again. So I have my new sensor. I cleaned up this plug here. Hopefully that'll be enough for it to read right. Plug it in. Make sure you hear that click.
So since it's so difficult to capture this on camera, we're just gonna show using props here.
So pretend this is the end of the cylinder head. This is how the coolant flange will be on the back of it. Always good to lubricate the O-ring. Put it on the coolant temp sensor. Plug on the electrical connector. Fish it down. And then you want to work it in. Until you can see that the metal part will get clipped in by the clip. So then you just fish in the clip and it's locked in. So the orientation of the sensor really does not matter because you can clip it in wherever. The only thing that is particularly important is to make sure it's fully seated.
So now that the sensor is in, I'm gonna break the seal on the cooling system, attach my pressure tester, check for any leaks. The sensor looks nice and square in the hole. I can see both sides are clipped and they are no leaks whatsoever. So now we can wrap it up. All right, so once you've leak checked it, next step is to bleed the cooling system real quick while double checking the coolant temperature. Clear codes. There we go, double checked. So we'll cycle the key. So in conclusion, it's not that hard of a job. There are a few little tricks I've learned throughout the years, which hopefully you saw in the video. Luckily, the coolant had not wicked through his wiring, so I cleared the fault and he's good to go. So if you like this video, give us a thumbs up, leave a comment, and subscribe for more content.